Hello everyone, today I will review the Algolaser Alpha laser engraving and cutting machine. Algolaser is a brand that many of us have just started to hear about. This brand produces laser engraving and cutting machines to meet the demands of both hobby and amateur users and small and medium-sized commercial enterprises. The model I will review today is Algolaser's Alpha model. Let's start examining it with its appearance and features. Then I will share with you some of the engraving and cutting examples I made. I will also share my usage experiences during this process. Alpha, in which red and black colors are preferred, has an all-metal solid body. The device, which has a wide cutting area, has a width and depth of 58.5 by 67.4 centimeters, and the cutting area is 40 by 40 centimeters. Algolaser Alpha has lasers with a total power of 22 watts. With an advanced reflection technology, it can collect these lasers in a 40% smaller area than its competitors, and thus it can perform well even at high speeds. With this power, Alpha can cut and engrave many different materials of various thicknesses, from wood to MDF, from acrylic to leather, from cardboard to thin metals. The device, which has a 32-bit motherboard and a dual-core processor, can reach speeds of 400 millimeters per second, which can be considered quite high compared to standard lasers. We can use Alpha by connecting it to the computer with a Type-C USB connection, and thanks to its wireless connection feature, we can also control it from our tablet or phone. Air support, which is generally offered as an option in laser engravers, comes standard in Alpha. This powerful air motor allows for a cleaner cut by reducing the heating effects of the laser during cutting. The device is quite eye-catching with its hardware and new technology laser head. It indeed looked like he could do very good work on paper. I also performed both engraving and cutting on many materials. I made my first experiments with the plywood. I could easily cut this 4 mm thick material. This is a display stand. Items such as decorative objects or photo frames can be placed on top of it. The black burn marks you see at the cut points are very normal. These can be removed by sanding or painting if desired. I also engraved on the same material. It gave great results in the two attempts, both on my own photograph and on a pattern. Since there are different shapes and tones in my photo, it may seem a little confusing. In such processes, the greater the contrast difference, that is, the clearer the black-white difference, the better the results. Therefore, the eagle pattern looks significantly much clearer and more beautiful. My next try was with a thicker MDF. I didn't do any engraving here. The same result can be obtained on MDF or any wooden surface. I only did the cutting performance test here once, and there was no problem with either geometric shapes or letters and numbers. Indeed, it was a very clean cut. This is a 6 mm MDF. The device was able to cut it in one go. However, on the Algolaser website, it is stated that the best performance for one-time cutting can be achieved with a 5 mm MDF for this material. Again, they shared it in a list on the site to show users what this device can and cannot do and to give us an idea. The max thicknesses of the materials that can be cut in a one pass and the max thicknesses cut in multiple passes are specified. Do not think that the materials that can be cut are just that. As I said, these are indeed shared only to give us an idea, actually. Another cutting example, I cut an acrylic YouTube logo. Again, it was a single cut as an example. I have cut acrylic before with different laser devices without air support and encountered excessive melting on the surface. Air support worked well here. Even though there were minor roughnesses, the cut was very clean with almost no melting. A similar situation occurred when working with felt. It was a very fast and clean cut. There was not even the slightest burning in the tiny round areas within the pattern you see. Again, I have encountered melting and burning situations on felt materials with lasers that do not have air support that I have used before. The power and speed of the laser and air support come into play here. The focusing of the laser beam, as I just said, can collect lasers in a 40% smaller area than standard lasers with an advanced focusing system. I'll briefly discuss this incident without confusing you. There is actually not a single laser in the laser head, you see. It contains more than one low wattage laser. These rays are reflected and focused on a single point. The total power of these lasers is 22 watts. And Algolaser Alpha focuses this significantly better than its competitors, or rather its peers. This has a greatly positive impact on the cuts we make in a beneficial way. In other words, when speed, power, new technology, and air support are combined, good results can be achieved without any burning or melting on the materials. Here's a corrugated cardboard cutout as well. The Harry Potter logo and the sorting hat that Harry Potter fans know. You likely guessed that it can cut cardboard after materials like plywood, MDF, and acrylic. The important thing here is that there are no burn marks. And it's a very sharp result. For example, let's say the sorting hat has a precise and fine cut right in the middle of the eyes. Indeed, it's very clearly visible. Again, the piece on the top is the same way, and I even kept the part coming out of that piece so I could show you as well. As you can see, although there are extremely fine details, sharp details. There is no burning or even structural deterioration, so you can cut even such small pieces out if you want. Again, when we look at HP, there are many sharp points. The tip of the letter P is very sharp, and the letter H also has thin and pointed parts. There was absolutely no structural damage or burning whatsoever here either, at all. I think it's a very successful result. After these works, I wanted to experiment a little on fabric and leather. Because especially those who want to use this device in the commercial field want to see its performance on fabric and leather. The exterior of this organizer is covered with a fabric-like faux leather. I engraved the brand's logo and the website of its distributor, Enmosphere, on it. The fine details, small letters, punctuations, or those sharp parts on the logo have turned out quite clear and nice. In the pattern work I did on real leather, I also crafted an eagle design. I had worked on an eagle in wood too, it was a coincidence. Benfica fans must have liked these works, although it was a logo related to the other bikers and Harley Davidson. Anyway, considering the pattern, I can say that it is perfect. It's as clear as if it were printed on a piece of paper. Even the sharp points such as its claws, beak, and the tips of its feathers are very sharp and clear. I embroidered this on such a shapeless leather. I thought I'd cut right and left and fix it. It was no different than cutting cardboard. It cut the leather cleanly in one pass without burning it or damaging its shape. I had slightly thicker leather on my hands. I cut various shapes out of it. There were some very small threads like this, but it is not a problem at all. The places I mentioned are spotless and can be easily cleaned. Probably even these points would not exist if a little more effort was made on them. It was one of the frequently asked questions in my previous laser reviews. How does it cut leather? Because many accessories, items, keychains, or similar products such as notebooks and diaries are made from leather. And laser machines make such work much faster and easier. Algolaser Alpha is an extremely adequate device for leather work. I recommend it, especially if you are going to deal with such things as fabric or leather. This is an experiment I made on fabric, a denim fabric. I embroidered a design that pleased my eye. The pattern looks quite nice. There aren't very fine details on it, but the process has been extremely successful. And now we come to the work on the metal. My first attempt was with a 0.2 meter thick metal card painted black on top in the box. it looked like they had put this here to be turned into a business card anyway. So that's what I did. I chose it because it's a detailed design, to be honest. In the end, it's quite nice. Fine details and text are extremely clearly visible. You can also make very similar engravings on any painted metal. One of the interesting features of Alpha Laser is that it can print in color on steel plates. It seems interesting at first, so how can laser give color? In fact, it is not only the laser that gives the color, but also the feature of the steel. Steel reacts differently to laser frequency, power, speed, and focal length of different intensities, and these reactions create colors. According to Algolaser's website, it is possible to create more than 500 shades of color on a steel plate with the Alpha model. I wanted to do an experiment. I created a pattern by applying different speeds and laser power. The result was quite beautiful. Blue, yellow, red, purple, gray, and black, all the colors are visible. The fine details and sharp parts also look nice in the same way. It's not like it was colored with a pencil. The contrast isn't too intense. However, the colors are quite distinct and beautiful. I also think that this feature will definitely have a nice effect, especially on souvenirs and accessories, and will encourage creative thinking. To summarize in general terms, you can process many materials with Algolaser Alpha, and as the company says, it is a powerful and beautiful device that can meet both hobby users and small and medium-sized commercial enterprises. I think 6 to 10 millimeter wood is ideal for those who want to cut and engrave MDF. Various thicknesses of fabric, leather, acrylic, or those who want to work on steel, as I just showed. Air support works very well, significantly reducing or completely eliminating burn marks. The work it does is good. I like the device, but apart from that, I would like to give you a warning and a suggestion. Never try to check the status of that cut or engraving with the naked eye while the laser is working. A small reflection at that time may hit your skin or eyes. This can cause serious health problems. Therefore, when you use the device or want to observe, I strongly recommend that you wear these protective glasses that come in the box. In fact, I say definitely use it. Definitely. Coming to the suggestion part, there are specifically cutting tables, commonly known as honeycomb, used for cutting. Mine is different, but Algolaser also has a cutting table measuring 40x40. This both protects the floor on which the laser stands and helps significantly eliminate burn marks and soot by providing airflow from below, improving the overall process. That's why I recommend getting one of these cutting boards along with the device when you buy it. It will be very useful for you. That's all I have to say about Algolaser Alpha. I hope you liked the video and it was useful for you. If you want one, you can buy it from the Algolaser Global Sales site or authorized distributors. So how did you find this device? I am waiting for all your comments, thoughts, opinions, suggestions, and questions. See you in the next video. Goodbye.